Hi, aloha, welcome to Obsuna. Obsessions. Gostaram pra saber, não? Okay, so welcome to another teacher series of the vlog, Obsuna Obsession. So by the way, I just finished my 4-hour shift, 4-hour stitching shift. So all my implements, all my props are scattered in here. So this is the one that I'm using as a ball. So if you are a PE teacher, you understand how far this will go. You're able to make or come up with the entire unit of having this. Anyway, that's not the point of this vlog. The vlog is about silver lining. Say it again, silver lining. I am going to focus on the bright sides of remote teaching. Today we will be speaking about ano ba yung mga silver lining para sa mga teachers. Meron yan. So, I thought of listing down what are the silver lining of the teachers doing the remote teaching. So, I came up with several answers here. I just listed it down here. Bakit bang arte ko magsalita? Arte talk. Ito yung arte talk. I just finished my shift and feeling ko may tuwang, may swag pa yung dila ko. Medyo nakabaluktot pa siya. So, parang kasi from class, I go directly to vlogging. Parang nandun pa. Kaya medyo magpasensya, medyo nandun pa. Pag nagsasalita na lang ako ng Tagalog, medyo i-straight na yung Tagalog ko. Yun. Anyway, bakit ko may na-explain? Nood lang kayo, wag lang mag-explain. Okay, so as I made mention that we will be discussing about the silver lining of doing the remote teaching, especially for the teachers. Today, we will be discussing the bright sides, benefits, and some brighter opportunities of doing such. Let's get started. One would be the use of chemicals. Okay, anyway, just a big disclaimer. This listed example that I'll be giving to you are all empirical and only based on my personal experience. Oh, kaya nga empirical eh. Ano ba ibig sabihin? Based only from my personal experience. And I'm not generalizing. Generalizing. Okay, stereotyping. Okay, the first is the use of the chemical. Since this lockdown happened, namahinga. Hirap kasi, English ka pa na English. Namahinga. My body get some rest from the chemical that I'm using, because before, during my normal life, I used to put a lot of sunscreen. I used to put some cream, sunscreen, you know, moisturizer on my face and throughout my body. But now, since the lockdown has started, it got rested. I'm not even applying anything on my body and my face right now. Also with my hair, before I used to, nowadays during the lockdown, I used to only shampoo my hair twice a week. I don't know if that is healthy or what, but yeah, before I used to have to put some wax and gel whenever I go to duty, but now since I'm just doing it at home, I'm not putting anything. I think that's a good sign. Oh, one more thing is about deodorant. Kumakaano naman ako sa likod. So since lockdown, I am not using and putting on or wearing the deodorant. 2 times a week, I used to put some alum tawas, the like the Durog. On the Durog tawas part. yung tawas na Durog. Kasi ang paniniwala nun dati, ba't pag gumagano na ako? Kasi nakakapagod na. Napagod ako sa 4 hours kung tuturo. Anyway, yung Durog na tawag, nakakaputi daw yun ang kilikili. Kaya yun yung sabi nila. So, my body got rested and at least detoxify from such body chemicals. Ang galing. Number 2 would be old clothes. Ito. Yung old clothes ko na to. Napansin nyo, hindi siya fit sa akin because maliit na siya. Kaya hindi ko pinapakita yung mataba ko kasi mataba siya. Oo, mataba siya. Old clothes means I am now able to use and wear my old clothes. Kasi since in remote teaching, ito lang naman yung nakikita. Okay, so might as well, pagsusuotin ko na yung mga, hindi ko na nasusuot, yung mga, kasi lumaki na ako. Yung mga old clothes ko. Tapos, syempre, boxer short lang tayo. Yes, I'm only wearing boxer short right now. So, that's, I think, one of the silver linings na you get to wear your old clothes. And down there, you can, you know, wear whatever you want and comfortable to you. And yeah, so, yun yung isa sa mga silver linings. Next is new skill, learning new skills. This is the perfect time for us teacher to learn new life skill. Ang galing ko na magluto ngayon. ang galing ko na, hindi ko na i-mention yung mga YouTube. Sa YouTube University lang yon. Ang galing ko na magluto ngayon kasi what else should I do? Reading a book also. I am now into reading books. Yes, and actually, binalikan ko lang yung book na binabasa ko before na I got stopped. I'm reading A Seven Habits by Stephen. Ito nga siya. Meron pala ako. Ito. I used to jot down notes kasi ang ganda talaga ng book na yun. Very empowering. So, yeah. Nandun ako sa book na yun. And if you happen to see my tweets, talagang ang ganda-ganda ng mga linya ng Seven Habits na yun. Aside from that, what are the new skills that we can learn during this lockdown situation? We can learn vlogging. We can learn some Adobe Photoshopping. So, there are so many things that we could learn. Why we need to learn new skills and life skill? Because as teachers, we are not, you know, we are not just what's the term? Hindi lang tayo basta compose, no, not cope. The term would be, hindi lang basta tayo close, okay, sa isa, sa teaching and learning. If you happen to understand, tayo mga teacher, we are a jack of all trades, we should be able to know this kind of skills, di ba? Kung meron tayong Adobe Photoshop skill, that would be an additional advantage, di ba? When making a report, di ba? Submission of presentation and everything. Pagod talaga ako, kaya ako nagaganito. The other silver lining would be nakakatipid sa gas. Oo, nakakatipid ako sa gas. Ako simula nung nag-lockdown, ang ginagawa ko lang, hinahatid ko lang yung misis ko. So, yung travel ko is 4 kilometers papunta at pabalik lang. Parang less than 4 pa lang pang-aatay. So, yung gas ko, umaabot siya ng 2 weeks. Yung dati kong 5 days, umaabot siya ng 2 weeks. So, sobrang tipid. Tapos, sa parking din, kasi dito sa Dubai, medyo have yung parking. Medyo nagmamaganda yung parking. So, nakakatipid ako. Kasi kung normal school time siya, hindi lang naman sa school ako nagpa-park. So, in between, pag sinabi ng misis ko na punta ka sa grocery, punta ka sa ganitong shop, do something, buy something, get something. So, whenever I go to one place, I need to secure parking. At yun nga, medyo nagmamaganda yung parking dito. So, medyo sayang din sa pera. Nakakatipid. The term is nakakatipid. Yes. Tsaka sa grocery, nakakatipid din kasi nowadays, since limited lang yung ating grocery time, we get to shop in bulk and ano yung opposite ng retail? Wholesale, yes. Now, we get to shop in a wholesale. Like, for example, in tissue. Before, binibili lang namin pa isa-isang tissue, ganun. Ngayon talaga, bumibili kami ng mga yung wholesale. The word is wholesale. Ganun din sa meat, ganun din sa toiletries, 'di ba? Lagi kaming wholesale. Kaya sabi namin kasi this is the only time na makagrocery kami. So get whatever we want and we can. So yun nga, nakakatipid naman. Kasi may difference yun eh kung bibili ka ng mga retail, mga sachet. So medyo nakakatipid ka sa groceries. Tapos pagdating naman sa technological inclination, tayo mga teachers, sabi ko nga sa previous vlog ko na wala naman talagang born na technologically gifted. Ngayon, ang ginawa lang sa atin ng lockdown is, binigyan niya tayo ng opportunity to search more. Oo. To search more. For example, ako, I'm teaching phys ed. Imagine yung music example ko. Bibilisan ko lang. Kung PE teacher ako, walang bola, walang court, walang field, walang pool, swimming pool, paano ako magtuturo, di ba? Walang space. Ang hirap. So, kailangan ko talagang baliin ang 360 yung instruction ko in order for me to deliver them the kind of instruction that they will be able to access. Ito na, magti-technical term na ako. Paano yun? Halimbawa, pag nagpagamit ka lang ng, halimbawa, nagpagamit ka ng sackball, oo, lahat sila may sackball, yes. That's why I came up with this idea. Paano kung may isang bata walang sackball, di ba? E di magiget left behind na siya. So, issue yon. So, kailangan, hanap ka ng isang instruction mo na dapat sila may access. My point here is, dahil sa technological inclination, tayo mga teachers, nagkakaroon tayo ng time para mag-research. Ngayon, I'm doing chess online. So, naghanap ako ng website, nag-aral ako ng website. Tapos, pagdating naman sa recording, nag-download ako ng Swiss System app. Alam ko na din yung peer deck, the way I am presenting every lesson, kailangan ko ng interaction and feedback. Ginagamit ko si peer deck, ginagamit ko din si Padlet just to show their evidences, ginagamit ko din si Jamboard. Ang dami kong natutunan. Super! Fantastic! Second to none! And now again, I think tomorrow we will be having a webinar about dojo class. So, ang dami, di ba? Ang dami ng mga inclination, ang dami ding additional knowledge para sa atin. Maganda naman yun kasi we are getting globally competent. Ang ganda, no? Globally competent. Whenever we go to teach, alam natin yung mga ganong kind of tools to access. Next is social media. In social media, ako, again, personally, nag-detoxify ako ng media, naka-deactivate yung Facebook ko, tsaka naka-logout yung Instagram ko. Back, kasi nakaka-stress, nakaka-stress yung mga fake news, and at the same time, you get to post nothing yun naman, kasi naka-lockdown ka, anong ipopost mo sa bahay? Hindi naman ako celebrity na konting breakfast ko lang, kukuhaan ko, magkakaroon ako ng number of likes, di ba? Parang, nothing is to post. And at the same time, makikita mo yung trend na parang, why these people from that part of the world are getting this kind of, you know, this kind of luxury of life, bakit tayo hindi? So, nagkakaroon ka rin ng inferiority complex na parang hindi siya healthy. So, deactivate. Okay, I am now active sa TikTok. Yun din yun eh. TikTok at saka, hindi, kasi TikTok is just a temporary. Ito yung sinasabi ko lang, temporary lang siya, na parang, ano lang siya, parang stress reliever. Reliever ko lang siya. Yun. When everything gets back to normal. So, babalik na ako ulit sa social media ko. But nevertheless, this is the time for us to detoxify to the stress environment of social media and go back to reading books. Mas maganda yun. Not only reading book, but also go back to learning new life skill. The other silver lining that I would like to tell is about, you get, you know, napaka-weird nito, pero I get to take a bath in between the class. Eh, ang gara, no? Kasi I and my assistant and my other co-PE teacher are in the room teaching at the same time we're doing a team teaching. So sometimes, pag si Mrs., hinahatid ko siya, I'm having a very, very less time to prepare in the morning, you know, eat, exercise, and, you know, take a bath. So sometimes, time na. So ang ginagawa ko for the first 20 minutes, I'm just, you know, making the class settle. Then after some time, sinasabi ko doon sa team ko na I'll be leaving after 20 minutes, tas kayo naman. So 15 minutes ako nagbabats, babalik ulit ako. Yun, so, ang weird, I get to take a bath in between the classes, di ba? Sobrang weird. Tapos, in between the classes, nakakatulog. Kanina may break akong 40 minutes, so naka-iglip pa ako. So, yun yung mga weird things na, ano. And lastly, I would like to share na this remote teaching, your family, for example, my wife, get to see how I behave whenever I'm on my teacher. But because when is the chance na makikita tayo ng family member natin on our teaching mode, di ba? Especially your immediate family, if you don't have wife or husband yet. So, kung may husband ka naman, you know, it's a bragging right, and at the same time, it takes pride na parang, oh, nakita ko ng hobby ko, ng wifey ko, na nagtuturo ako. So parang nagkakaroon pa tayo ng greater inspiration, and at the same time, nagkakaroon tayo ng power na galingan pa natin kasi parang sasabihin nila na, ah, ganito pala si SO, si significant other, di ba? Ako, personally, whenever my wife is around, ginagalingan ko kasi, ano yun, one way of making her prouder of me. So, yun lang. So, those are the silver linings of teaching online. Of course, again, those are empirical, basing on my own experience. And, yeah, I hope you learned something. It's just that if there are some brighter side of doing this thing, also, there are some negative. And I think that would deserve for another episode. But what I wanted to tell you, teachers, is you're doing good. Okay, you're doing good. Indirectly, you are on the second liner. You are a frontliner, but we are on the second line. Of course, yung mga medical staff are on the first line. But because millions of students around the world are depending on us, we are really doing the good job, and I can salute you for this. Yun lang, maging masipag lang tayo, and always, always be proactive. Whatever things that is happening on our profession right now with the situation we are having, always think that there is always a brighter side of things. I hope this silver lining episode helped you in identifying your strength and identifying your gift as a teacher. I'll see you on the next vlog. Thank you for watching Obsuna Obsession.